I'm Melissa Curtis. Welcome to my Pregnancy Yoga for a Good Night's Sleep yoga class, brought to you in partnership by VHI. Hello everybody, Melissa here. I have a lovely pregnancy yoga class for you guys today, and the theme is pregnancy yoga for sleep. So we're going to take our time, we're going to move relatively slowly, it depends how you're feeling today, and we'll do a lot of, you know, just folding forward poses, okay, which are much more calming, a couple of twists. And we'll work into the glutes, we'll kind of stretch out and release the glutes as well. If we're holding a lot of tension, we'll work on the jaw as well. If you have a birth ball at home and you prefer to be sitting on that and using it when you can during our class, by all means do that too. But for now, I'd like you to sit in a comfortable position. So that might be sitting on a couple of cushions. I have a block and a blanket with me for today. If you don't have a block, no problem. A book would be fine. You don't really have to have one though. But a blanket is handy, and as are cushions for comfort as well. So sitting cross-legged, you might even want to sit up against your ball with a wall behind it, or you can sit up on a chair or on your birth ball as well. You can sit kneeling if you would prefer that too. Whatever's most comfortable for you to focus on your breath. So we're going to start off with a squeeze and release technique. So we're going to very quickly tense our muscles and then relax them. And studies show that when we very quickly tense and release a muscle, it tends to relax even more. And this is an absolutely amazing little technique to do at the end of the day before you go to bed, or if you're just feeling like you're in a bit of a funk, I recommend you try this, or if you feel very tense. So first of all, it's going to look funny, but I'm going to scrunch all the muscles of my face towards my nose like this, and then I exhale and I let my muscles go. And we're going to go through the body like that, okay? So when you're ready, inhale. And then exhale, let them go. Fantastic. Now lift your shoulders up towards your ears as you breathe in. And as you breathe out, drop your shoulders down. Now make a fist, inhale, bring your fist towards your shoulders. And exhale, let them go. Now you're gonna tense your tummy muscles, okay? You're gonna squeeze your bum. So when you're ready, hug your baby, lift your pelvic floor, squeeze your bum. And exhale, release. Lovely. Now we're going to squeeze it like we're squeezing our legs in towards each other, like there's a block between the thighs. Inhale, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Exhale, release. Now push your toes away from you. So push into the balls of the feet, curl your toes back and relax your toes. Now we're going to do the whole body. So I want you to give yourself a hug. And we're going to inhale, squeeze every muscle in the body and exhale, relax and let go. It's a great way to release tension. Your hands are in whatever position is comfortable for you. Close your eyes. And just focusing on the breath. And today we're going to focus on what's called the pause or the gap. So follow your breath as you inhale. So feel the cool air entering in through your nose. Feel it move in towards your body. And then as you exhale, feel the air begin to leave your body out through your nose. Notice how the air is warmer. So follow your inhale from beginning to end, and follow your exhale from beginning to end. And now begin to notice, after you've inhaled, right before you exhale, notice the little pause, the little silence, and then you exhale, and then when you finish exhaling, it's almost like there's a pause. The whole body just holds for one more moment, and then you inhale again, and there's no holding the breath. This is all happening naturally. So when you finish inhaling, it's like the body holds on to that air for a split second more, and then it's a lovely release when you exhale. And then when you finish exhaling, it's like the body just takes a moment before letting the air back in. See if you can begin to drop into that pause, that gap, that moment. moment of stillness. It's very short, split second, after you've inhaled and before you've exhaled. And the same after you've exhaled, before you inhale. Drop into that pause, that silence. And just keep coming back to it. If your mind wanders, that's okay. Follow the inhale. Notice before you exhale. When you finish exhaling, notice before you inhale, and so on. Just continue this for a few moments more. Really nice. And this is something that, you know, your baby is accustomed to already. They're feeling it, and then as soon as they can hear, they're listening to your breath all the time. They probably are quite familiar with that little pause. Remember, it's natural. It's not something we're making happening, but it is there. And many women find this so nice and calming if their mind is busy. The early stages of birth as well, and if you wake up in the middle of the night, it's a nice one to come to. In between the contractions, it helps you save energy, helps you stay calm. And also when you're mothering your little one, resting beside them, you can focus on this little bit of silence in your breath. So if you haven't opened your eyes, open your eyes. We're going to stretch the legs out. Really nice. So you're going to circle out your ankles. So this is really good at night to do. Circling out the ankles helps bring the blood flow back up towards the heart. Okay, so for any of you who get calf cramps, I'm going to do a few things that might help prevent, but also help after one as well. Just stretching out the leg a little bit. Really good. But we're just getting the blood flow back up towards the heart with some movement. Beautiful. Okay. Now we're going to cross our legs again. So just crossing whatever is comfortable. If you want to put the opposite leg in front, do so. If you're sitting kneeling, that's okay. Or if you're on your birth ball, that's fine too. You're going to bring your right hand down and your left arm up and over. We're going to get a little wave-like motion going here. So we're going to exhale and go over to the other side. Inhale and then exhale. So just feeling that lovely wave-like motion. Good. And perhaps repeating to yourself as we do this. My mind is calm. My body is calm. My baby is calm. And again, my mind is calm. My body is calm. My baby is calm. And just that lovely flow going side to side is very calming. We'll do a couple of pelvic tilts now. So I'm going to change the cross of my legs just so I'm not always going to the same side all the time. Let's get the butt out a little bit. So tail out, back onto the sit bones, and we'll do some pelvic tilts. So getting rid of tension in the upper back more than anything. So I'm going to bring my hands into this cactus position. I'm going to breathe in, squeeze my shoulder blades towards my spine, lift my heart up. And as I exhale, I'm going to give my baby a nice hug and bring my elbows together, hands together. Inhale, breathing in, lifting your chest up, and then exhale, rounding your back. So nice, everybody. Inhale. So feel that tilt in your pelvis as well. Exhale. And two more. Inhale, tilting forward, opening the front body. Exhale, tilting back, opening the back body, and release. Fantastic. So stretching your legs out, give them a nice little bit of a shake. Let's come on to all fours, come off our sit bones. So I recommend you just put your cushions to the side and put the blanket underneath your knees, okay? So, I'm here. I'm going to do a couple of cat stretches, which are really nice for your low back and actually your middle back as well. And we're going to give baby a nice big hug as well. So you're going to come on to all fours, your wrists under the shoulders, knees underneath the hips, okay? okay? Spreading your fingers. And remember, it's okay to make a fist if you don't like being on your hands, or if you have anything that you could put underneath your forearms, you could do that if it's too much for your wrists, okay? So we're gonna take a breath here. And as we exhale, I want you to draw your navel in, round your back, and lift your middle spine to the ceiling. Inhale, we come back to a neutral spine. So neutral, I mean I'm not letting my ribs flare out and I'm not collapsing into my low back, okay? All the curves are in their natural curvy shape. This is a great one to do postnatally as well. Exhale, rounding the back so you feel your sphincters hug up into your pelvis. The pelvic floor draws up. You're hugging your baby. Say hi to your baby bump, okay? And then inhale, coming back here. Let's do that again. Exhale, rounding, hugging your baby, bringing the chin in towards your chest. Inhale, a nice long spine. And then exhale, moving the forehead and the pubic bone towards each other. Inhale, let's do one more. Okay, great. Exhale, rounding. And then inhale, lengthening. We're going to walk the hands back and just do a couple of kneeling hip circles. So keep your knees about hip width, making sure you're on a cushion, and just circling out the hips here. Really nice. So just breathing in and out through your nose. We're in no rush right now, okay? So doing some movement, you know, about an hour before you go to bed can be really nice when you're pregnant. Just if you're going to bed feeling stiff, you might have such a nice sleep. Switch directions if you haven't already. So maybe picking out one or two of these yoga poses, maybe four or five, that really suit you, that you felt really helped you, benefit. You don't have to do a full hour or the relaxation at the end even. Just something to prepare your body for a good night's sleep, okay? So we're gonna come back down onto all fours and do that lovely wave-like motion. So your knees are on padding, your hands are in front, your knees are whatever distance apart that feels good for you. I'm gonna press my hands into the floor, round to my back like that cat stretch. Then I'm gonna reach my sit bones back towards the heels. I'm gonna inhale and come forward, gliding along the mat. You can curl your toes if that's nicer. Rounding back and then coming forward. So let's just go nice and slow. So especially if you've had a busy day, you might find yourself going really fast. So let's slow it down. Let's prepare the body to wind down. Let's encourage the body to release calming hormones. Really nice. Breathing in and breathing out. So nice for your back. Lovely, we'll do two more, okay? That's one. Feel that lovely wave-like motion running through your body, especially your spine. And then come back to center. Okay, so we're gonna come into tailor pose. I'm just gonna sit on my blanket. And we're gonna work into the buttock muscles. So just relieving tension more than trying to get too much out of it, okay? You know, I would recommend not sitting on a block if you're sitting on something high, because you're going to be rocking side to side. So bring the soles of the feet together. Now, if this doesn't suit pubic bone pain, and crossing the legs does, by all means, you can do everything in this position here. You can rock a little bit side to side. Or else, if you want to come to a kneeling position, where you put the cushions underneath your sit bones and your sitting in between your heels with your toes pointing back, sitting up high, that'll take any pressure in the pubic bone out if you're not liking what we're about to do, okay? So sitting down, and this is for those of you who get that ache in the arse, you know, where you just feel like you want to get an elbow in there and really get in. This is a really nice one to do. So I'm holding onto the wrist, lifting up through the crown of the head, bending the elbows inside the knees, and I'm gonna rock side to side. So if this doesn't suit your pelvis, you can bring your arms side to side. Okay, so just move one arm over and across. Lovely, otherwise just rocking. And you'll feel like we're drawing a big smile across each butt cheek. And that's getting into a muscle called the piriformis, and it can get a little tight and the sciatic nerve goes through there. So sometimes this kind of movement feels really good, especially if you wanna go to bed and it's at you, this can release. But keeping the chest up, so try not to be all hunched and rounded, okay? Try and lift up through the crown of the head. Good, and rock, and give that bum and all massage, okay? Lovely. It's almost like getting a ball or an elbow in there. And then come back to center. Breathing in, lovely. And a big sigh out through your mouth, letting it all go. Bring your hands underneath your knees and lift your knees up. Now we're going to come back onto all fours. And this is really good for anyone who gets that kind of hip ache, you know, especially at night. If you're in the one position for a while, it's just kind of an achy sensation down the side of the thigh. This is a real winner sometimes amongst women. But everyone's different. So if something doesn't feel right, then I would try and do less or just not do it at all. So you're going to bring your wrists under the shoulders, knees under the hips. Again, if you want to make a fist, you can. I'm going to stretch my right leg out. I'm hugging baby. And I'm getting a nice calf stretch here, okay? So hopefully avoiding any calf cramps later, who knows? I'm gonna imagine that I'm balancing a full glass of water on my sacrum and I don't wanna spill even a drop. So I slide my right foot over to the left. I keep my toes on the floor. If you find your right hip has dipped as I'm showing you now, lift your right hip up, find balance in the pelvis again. Push out through the heel. Now you'll feel this lovely sensation down across the outer right thigh. Then turn your head and look over your left shoulder at your right foot. So now we're getting a nice opening across the ribs and a little squeeze into the opposite ribs. Lovely. And into your neck as well. Shoulders down. Then bring your head, look back in between the hands, slide your right foot down and bring your right knee onto the floor. We're gonna stretch out the opposite leg, okay? So find the balance. You can even put a yoga block on your sacrum, okay? Or put a book just to see if your pelvis, especially if you're experiencing pain, I don't mean during the yoga class, but in general in the back hip area, you know, just be careful, keep balance all the time, all right? What I mean is hips in alignment. So I'm gonna slide my foot over, my left foot, see how the toes stay on the floor. And see how if I drop my hip, the block might start to slide, okay? So I don't want that. I want the block to stay on my sacrum all the time. So I'm sliding over, my hips are balanced, I'm reaching through the chest, turning my head to look over my shoulder at my foot. So all along my left side, the outer side is getting this lovely stretch, and all along my right side is getting a lovely little squeeze. Then look forward, slide your foot back, take the book or the block off if you have one there. Come down onto your forearms and let's do a nice pelvic floor sigh. So just rock your hips side to side. Lovely everyone. Breathing in and out through your nose. Great. Do a few tilts here. Tuck the tailbone, stick the tailbone out. Just giving the pelvic floor a little bit of release. This is great for circulation as well when we release. So if we've been gripping a lot, if you had a very busy day, you're more than likely gripping into the pelvic floor, gripping the cervix. So this is a nice way to just let it all go. Lovely. You're going to bring one hand onto the floor and then the other hand onto the floor. And just come up onto your knees for a moment while we do some wrist. Okay, so we're going to interlock the fingers, squeeze the elbows and just circle out your wrists a couple of times in one direction. Breathing in and out through your nose and a couple of times in the other direction. Lovely. And now we'll do one of my favorite. It's called cleaning the barrel, and it's just like flossing the shoulders, okay, the shoulder blades, that there's points, like the rhomboids muscles that get very tight. So you're going to, again, have your knees on something if you wish. Your hands are going to be as wide as your shoulders, okay? And we're going to draw big circles with our rib cage. So imagine your ribs are inside a barrel and you're just sweeping along the inner surface. And for anyone whose upper back is at them, or for anyone who's got that tightness, a lot of times in pregnancy, as everything moves forward from the front, we get tight in the back. So usually lower back or in between the shoulder blades, okay? And then go the other direction. But this is nourishing, encouraging circulation, and just squeezing and releasing out those areas. So it's so nice. It's one of my favorites to do earlier in the morning when I wake up very stiff, okay? One more, and then come back. Just come up onto your knees for a moment and just give your wrists a little bit of a shake. So we're only going to do a few standing poses because I want to bring everything down a little bit, okay? You know, just bringing the energy levels down a little bit, just getting prepared for sleep. So just coming up slowly. So you're going to bring one leg out in front, curl your back toes. Imagine there's a block between your thighs, hands down. Take a breath in. As you exhale, hug in. So hug baby, squeeze the inner thighs together, press down. and come all the way up. Lovely. So I'm going to take the blanket off my mat so I don't fall, okay? And I'm going to put it here. Lovely. So we're going to use the wall now again for a little bit of release, and it's some good positions for birth too. So I'm just going to turn my mat around for a second here, all right? Just using it to stand on so I don't slip. Again, I'd prefer you to be in your bare feet. Okay, and I'm going to stand on the mat now, and I'm going to face the wall. And you're going to put your forearms onto the wall and your head onto the wall, and we're going to do some hip circles. So I'm going to show you first, then I'm going to turn around so I can talk to you. So have a look at me. I'm going to place down here. I lean into the wall. I'm really using the wall for support. And you're going to start to circle out your hips like this. And then we'll go the other way. So finding even the back of a door or the a wall somewhere. Even if you've just got a lot going on in the house at the moment, you can just put your hands onto the back of a couch and do this as well. But close your eyes and really lean into the wall. So use the wall. The wall is supporting you. Just reach into it. Let go. Imagine the wall's almost holding you. And start to circle out your hips. And think of that spiral shape. So have the image of a spiral in your head as you circle around. Really nice. And this is, again, a movement that can feel really good when you're birthing your baby, whether you're standing, sitting on a ball, kneeling, leaning forward, kneeling, sitting upright, into a chair, kneeling into a ball. There's so many positions. Now we're going to go the opposite direction. This time I'd like you to breathe in through your nose and blow out through soft parted lips. Leaning into that wall. Imagine you're in the shower and the water's pouring down you, soothing any discomfort in the back or the hips. And just blow out through soft parted lips, rose petal lips again. Gorgeous. And again, one more. So nice. And now just pause. You're leaning against the wall. Just pause here. Okay, great. And you're going to slowly push away from the wall and bring your hands down. Now we're going to do a really nice stretch into the back. Okay, so just have a look at me though. You can even use the back edge of a couch. If the couch is high enough, it feels really good. Or a wall is great. So I'm going to move my mat back so my feet are on the mat all the time, so I'm not going to slip. I'm going to bring my hands onto the wall. I'm going to start to walk back. So you can see how my wrists and shoulders are pretty much in line. I'm bending my knees. My knees are really bent. And I'm reaching the hips behind me as I press into the wall, okay? So from the side, it looks like this. I look like a 90 degree angle, two sides of a box, and I'm pushing against the wall. And it's really nice for getting space into the back. A little bit of hugging the baby. So let's do this together. So face your wall, be quite close to it. Put your fingertips, hands on the wall, fingertips pretty much in line with your lower ribs. You're going to walk your hands back, or your feet back, excuse me, and walk back until your ankles are in line with your hips, thereabouts. Now you're looking straight down so that the neck is in line with the rest of the spine. You're going to walk back. You're bending into your knees, you're pushing away from the wall with your hands, and you're just getting a nice stretch. You're hugging baby, okay, the chin is not tucking into the chest. There's enough space for a little tangerine between your chin and your chest, okay? Really nice. Now, if you're feeling very rounded, so if you're on the wall and your back is super rounded, you don't feel like you're getting any length into it, walk your hands up higher, and that's perfect just to do as well. Now, to come out of it, I want you to bend your knees, hug your baby with your tummy muscles, and start to walk your feet towards the wall slowly as you come up. Really nice. Just turn to face me here. Soften your knees. And we're just going to do a couple of little twists. Okay, so a little bounce into the knees as I twist, straighten, bounce. So as my arms go around to the side, I bend my knees. Now, if you get dizzy in pregnancy, just keep looking straight ahead. So sometimes when we follow the hands with the gaze, it's all a bit too much. That's fine. Just doing this. Perfect, everybody. Really nice. And whatever, looking forward or side to side is perfect. And just come back to center and just pause here in mountain pose for a moment. You're going to breathe in, lift your shoulders up towards your ears. And breathe out, open your mouth. Inhale, lift your heels up off the floor on your tippy toes. And then exhale, come down. Lovely. Okay, so we're going to take a nice big step out. We're going to do a forward fold, opening up the chest, bringing the head lower than the heart, which can feel great. It's great to kind of reverse gravity a bit. But if you have heartburn, you're just going to go halfway if it's all just a bit too much. Okay, so we're going to bring our arms behind. You're going to interlock your fingers. So it's like this from behind. Okay. And your toes are pointing forward. Now I want you to imagine the block is between your thighs. So we've got a good bit of hip stability going on. I'm squeezing that imaginary block, rolling my shoulders up and back, reaching my knuckles back. And even now you can feel that squeeze into perhaps a tight area in your body in between the shoulder blades. I'm gonna hinge forward, do bend your knees, hinge forward from the hips. So I'm not changing the shape of my spine. All the curves stay in their natural shape. And this is probably ideal for anyone who has heartburn. I would recommend you stay here. If you feel any backache, you can always put your hands on your thighs. Okay, but if you'd like to go a little further, you're going to hinge forward even more. You're going to start to feel a bit of a lengthening sensation in the backs of the legs. Bend the knees more if it's too intense, shoulders back, and then just let your head relax. So the neck is getting a complete break, and just look to one side slowly. A really slow movements, the other side slowly. And come back to center. Now bend your knees, release your hands down onto your thighs, and as you come up, reach through the chest, reach your butt out behind you, draw your belly in, so we come up nice and safe for the back. And just take a moment, see how you feel after that. Oh, sometimes you can feel woo, tiny bit dizzy, so just again, remember I was saying to just look along the floor, come up slowly, focus on your breath, and then sometimes you can just feel like you've just released something, whether it's in the head or in the body. It can be quite uplifting, that particular move. So we're going to scissor the feet in together here. Lovely. And we're going to go back down onto the floor. So let's crawl down. I'm going to go to the back of the mat. I'm going to put my hands on the thighs. I'm going to reach my hands out, crawling, crawling, crawling. And we're going to do a really nice pose called pigeon pose or swan pose. I like to call it in pregnancy as well. It really depends how your knees are as well. So I want you to really listen to me as we go through the instructions with this. Have a cushion nearby. We might be shoving that underneath the back of one of our thighs. And you can also have a blanket if you want underneath the knees. But the knees move back a little bit. So have the blanket kind of towards the back of your mat, not right in the middle. Okay, and you can even open it out more if you wish, like this. Okay, just to make sure you're not going to miss your knees. So you're going to come onto all fours. I'll do this side first so you can see me. I'm pressing down through the hands. I'm going to bring one knee forward, this knee. See how it's just coming inside my wrist? And I'm going to bring my foot forward. So I'm almost bringing it towards the opposite hand, my right hand. And I'm pressing my toenails into the floor. I'm going to curl my toes, lift my knee, and start to scoot that leg back. See how I'm inching my back leg further back, further back, further back. And I feel a lovely sensation of lengthening in the front groin, and I feel a nice stretch kind of getting into that glute area here. Now, how's your knee? It's really important that your knee's okay in this. So we have a saying in yoga that you can mess with the gods, but you can never mess with your knees. So let's keep the knees quiet. If you feel discomfort in your knees, you can always come a little bit more forward, okay, and really use your hands. Or you can even take the pressure out of the knee and almost try and move that back leg further back. And sometimes that works. It just depends. If you feel like you're very tilted, so if you feel like this glute is almost collapsing to the floor, get your cushion and stuff it under here, like that. Or a yoga block would work as well, okay? And then we're up on our hands. You can come up onto your fingertips. I'm going to keep my back toes curled. So there's a little bit of hugging in. There's a little bit of action to support me. Staying here or taking your cushion or cushions if you need to be higher. And come down onto your forearms. Press the toenails of the front foot into the floor. So you're flicking your toenails into the ground. Shoulders are relaxed. You're breathing in and out through your nose. Now, some of you might be quite familiar with this, and you might already have made a pillow with your hands and be resting down on the ground. Just be mindful that your pelvis is balanced. We're not rolling too much to one side. And make sure your knees are happy. Breathing in and out through your nose. Good. If you feel like it's too much, you can always come back up onto your hands like this. But it can be so nice across one side of each glute and thigh. So let's take a nice, long, slow, deep breath in. And then open your mouth, sigh. There's a bit of a sweet and sour feeling to this pose. Like it's so nice, yet you can feel like it's really getting in somewhere that's a bit tight. Now to come out of it, just put your cushion to the side for a moment, curl your back toes, and just lift the back knee up and move forward. So you see how I'm rolling onto my toes here, I'm dropping my knee, and I'm gonna keep using that back foot to help me get back up into more of an all four position. I'm gonna slide my foot back, I'm gonna bring this knee down onto the ground, lovely. And I'm just gonna take a few hip circles. So just slowly, slowly circling around, really nice. And then we're going to go the opposite direction. Really good. Really nice. Just easing out that area. Really gorgeous. So we're going to do the other side now, and you'll actually see me from, you know, a different direction, which is good. So I'm going to bring my right knee up towards my right wrist, or just do the opposite leg. Now, your foot, you know, you might need to keep your heel quite underneath your glute and just do this and open the knee out. That might be enough for your knee. Or you're going to bring, see how I'm sliding my foot forward, and that's about as far as my knee will allow me to go. Some of you might even bring the foot all the way up where the shin is parallel to the front. So long as your knee is fine, that's okay. Now, all the way here, I want you to press your toenails into the floor, okay? So we're protecting the knee by doing that, so flicking them down. Curl your back toes and start to inch back here like this, okay? There's a bit of wiggling going on, a bit of adjusting. Feels really nice. Keep going for it, okay? If not, you can always come out onto all fours and do some hip circles. And then I feel like that's as far as I'm gonna go. If you wanna get your cushion or even two cushions, feels really nice, okay? Keep pressing the toenails into the floor. Come down onto your forearms. Stay up. There's quite an arch in the low back here. If there's any pinching, move forward. But the more we move forward, the more we relax and melt into it. So this is where the restorative part comes. So you're going to breathe in and out through the nose and just completely rest. You know, just don't worry where you are. If you're looking at me lying on the ground and, you know, you're up here, that's fine too. Remember, listening to your body is the best lesson you can have. Or give yourself. So whatever it is, just hold it for a few moments more. Soften the shoulders. Just notice you tensing the neck, the jaw. Let it go. Take a nice, long, slow, deep breath in and then sigh out. See if you can let go of that gripping of the buttocks. Double check. Are you still balanced? Are you rolling to one side? So balance out your back hips. And then we're going to slowly come up. So your hands help you up first of all. I'm going to take the cushions out to the side and I curl my back toes if they're not, and just start to move your knee a little bit further forward. So we take the pressure out of the front leg, slide the foot underneath. Great. And now I'm going to bring that knee back down. Lovely. And just rocks, draw these U shapes, curl your toes and just draw little U shapes with your pelvis as we go like this. Really, really nice. Great. Easing it all out. Twists are very restorative for the body too. So staying where you are, you're going to bring one hand underneath your face. Okay, it's my left hand here, keeping my knees on a little bit of padding. I'm going to bring my right arm out and I'm going to thread that arm through all the way. I'm just going to rest my side of my face down. Okay. If you want to put a cushion underneath your head, if that's a bit nicer, if you want to bring the floor to you. So my hips are reaching up, my sit bones are reaching up, and I'm getting a nice little twist here. If it's too much, if you're feeling like you just don't have enough space, then you can stay up and just go like this, okay? No problem. Really nice. So whatever really is nicest for you, that's what you're going to do. Great. And we're going to press into that hand on the floor, slowly come up, and you're going to do the other side, whether you have a cushion or not, okay? So again, if that's all a bit too much, so we're going to put the other hand under the face. You can just reach the hand out like this. See the way I'm doing that? You can do that, or you can come all the way down onto your forearm, reach your hand out away from you, and rest your head down. So staying there, it's a nice equal twist for your neck, and you'll feel it in your upper back as well. So just holding there for another breath. And then we're going to press into the hand, slowly, slowly, slowly come up. Lovely. We're going to just come to a seated position for a moment here. A few more little twists and neck release and sitting on something if you wish. Crossing your legs or sitting kneeling. You could even be on a birth ball doing this as well. You're going to breathe in, bring your arms up overhead. And as you breathe out, you're going to rotate to the right. So hand on the knee, hand behind you. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. Think of that back shoulder moving back. Good. Only turning as far as feels comfortable on your neck. Just be very careful of pinching. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale and twist. And then turning your head back to center. Let's go to the other side. Inhale up. Exhale over. Inhale, lengthen. Draw the shoulder back and twist. Softening that jaw. And then coming back to center. Lovely. And now we're going to breathe in and we're going to do a little flow. So as you exhale, one hand comes in front, one hand in the back. Touch the floor, then inhale back up. Exhale and twist. Inhale up. Exhale, twist. Good. And again, breathing in. And breathing out. Lovely. And again. One more time. Center, bring your hands behind you and just move your fingertips away from you. Draw your shoulders back, lift your heart up, open up that front body. Good, nice. Feel that lovely space in the front of your body. And then look forward, walk your hands forward. Nice. Now you're going to interlock your fingers behind your back and you're going to make a fist and bring your fist to the left side of your waist and pull your elbow back. See how it's out like this. Draw your elbow back, shoulders back. Really nice. Now I'm going to tilt my head over to that side where the fist is. So I'm going to tilt my left ear towards my left shoulder. And just bring your chin in. Feel that in the neck. And lift your chin up. Good. Just let the ear hang over the shoulder. Drop your chin down towards your chest. Release your hands and bring your fist over to the other side as we look down. Draw your elbow in. Lovely. You're going to roll your right ear over your right shoulder. Soften your jaw, soften your face. Close your eyes if you want. And now bring your chin in. Keep pulling the elbow back behind you. And lift your chin up. And then bring it down a bit, just let the head hang. And now drop your chin down. Bring the knuckles back behind you, lift your heart. And exhale, release. Inhale, interlock your fingers. Exhale, turn your palms forward. Lift your arms up and release. Bring your hands behind you, put the opposite index finger on top. Squeeze again, release. Interlock your fingers, turn your palms away, lift your arms up, and exhale, release. Lovely. Now we're going to find the skin on our chest here, okay? So I want you to think of where your collarbones are, and you're going to pull the skin down. It's like you're trying to drag the skin down away from your collarbones. It feels really nice in the neck. This is great for being on a computer or phone all day. We're going to look up, feel that stretch. And very slightly tilt your head to the right, your right ear to right shoulder. come back to center and tilt to the other side. Be very mindful and slow with your neck. Lift up and look forward. Really good. And you're going to bring your hands into an L shape. Let's cross the opposite leg in front. Good. And you're going to bring your thumbs behind your hip and your fingers at the front. Now, if you find this uncomfortable, just put your hands on your knees. It's no problem. So we're just supporting the tops of our thighs. We're pressing down into the tops of the thighs here. You're going to come forward, up, back, and around. And again, forward, up, back, and around. So it's like that wave-like motion we did when we were on all fours. Now we're doing it seated. So as you come forward, press your hands into the tops of your thighs, lift your shoulders up towards your ears, and then roll back again. Two more. Moving with your breath, everybody. If you want to blow out through those rose petal lips, please go ahead and do so. And release. Okay, so we're going to come onto all fours for our last yoga pose before hopefully you have a lovely night's sleep. And we're going to make a bit of noise, actually. We're going to make a bit of sound. Good to get used to making sound. You know, you might naturally make sound when you're giving birth. Okay, so we're gonna make some nice deep sounds. We're gonna come onto all fours. Okay, we're gonna put the blanket underneath your knees. And we're gonna start to draw circles like this. Okay, so first of all, just breathe in through the nose, lick your lips, and blow out through soft, parted lips. Really good. Now we're going to go the other direction. You're going to breathe in. And you're going to go, ah. Think of a real joy sound going down through your body, down to baby. Okay, again, inhale. Ah. Two more, inhale. Really let the sound be deep and moving down rather than high pitched. And again, let it relax your jaw. Lovely, everyone. And pause. And let's get ready for a nice long relaxation. Okay, so for those of you who'd like to get into bed, I recommend you do. Or if you want to lie on the couch, I recommend you do that as well. If you're going to lie on your side, lie on your right or your left side, that's up to you. Okay. But you might want to put something underneath your hips. If you're lying on your left side, it is a good idea after 34 weeks. Try not to let it be an obsession unless that's the only comfy side for you. But just promoting, you know, a good position for baby to get into, preparing for birth. And you can prop yourself up with lots of cushions. If you're lying on your back, no problem at all, okay? But just make sure that you turn on your side to lie down and turn your side to come up. And you might like to keep the knees bent, feet on the floor. Unless your legs are straight, put a cushion under your knees, please. Okay? If you're lying on your right or your left side, just snuggling up. Sometimes your hands get in the way. A cushion between the hands can feel really nice. A little cushion underneath your baby bump. And then, of course, something between your knee and your ankle as well is recommended. Okay? So take a few moments to get comfy, or perhaps run to the loo and run back before we begin. So hopefully you're as comfortable as you can be. I know the word comfy in pregnancy can be an interesting word to use, but as comfortable as you can be. If you can dim the lights, create a nice setting. A setting, one that you might be in when you're, you know, at home and birth starts and you're, you know, at home before you head into the hospital. Trying to create that nice setting so that your body can release hormones to help labor move along. But for now, just get used to making that setting. Close your eyes. And bring your awareness all the way up to the crown of your head, right up there. And as you breathe out, imagine a beautiful liquid light showering down over the top of your head, smoothing and soothing down through all the muscles of your scalp. Feel all the muscles of your scalp soften and smoothen. And allow that feeling of soft liquid light flowing down across your forehead. Feel your eyes relax back into their sockets. Feel it flowing down across your temples, cheekbones, jaws. Feel your face and your head soft and smooth. And feel this calming liquid light flowing and glowing down through your upper neck, down through your middle neck, and into your lower neck. And just feel it flowing and glowing down and across and into your shoulders. Feel your shoulders melt into the frame of your body. And allow this soft awareness to flow and glow down through your upper arms, your elbows, your lower arms, your wrists, your fingers, so that your arms can rest. Let your arms completely relax. Arms that will soon hold your little one. For now, just let them rest. Breathing in, feel the belly rise and the chest rise. And as you breathe out, feel this lovely melting sensation flow and glow down through your upper back, your middle back, your lower back. Whole back soft, whole back relaxed. Going a little bit deeper now, down across the chest and into and through your ribs. Let this soft liquid light flow down through your torso, down across the belly, and then deeper into the belly, deeper and deeper down towards the pelvis where your baby is or babies are. And imagine this calming liquid light glowing and flowing and surrounding your baby with a sweet and calm awareness, sending a message of love, of peace and calm to your baby. Imagine your baby bathing in this calming light, completely at ease. And then going a little bit deeper down, down into the pelvis, relaxing any tension in the pelvis and the hips. Feel your whole pelvis just bathing in this sense of calm, this calming light. Whole pelvis now soft, heavy, relaxed. Going down deeper and deeper still, down through the thighs, knees, calves, shins, ankles, feet, toes. Feel your legs completely relaxed. Let your legs go. And now feel your whole body, you and your baby, whole body glowing radiant all over, inside, outside, bathing in this sweet, calm, peaceful awareness. Whole body relaxed, whole body completely relaxed. Take a moment, feel your body resting in the afterglow from your yoga class, resting, relaxing. Stay where you are if you can. Take longer to rest and save energy. But if you would like to move and continue on with whatever needs to be done, then feel free to start to move your body. Just invite your body to move whatever way feels the most comfortable for you. You might like to take a nice big breath in and then sigh out through the mouth. And then once you feel like you've moved your body just a little bit, we don't want to stretch and move too much, just enough to take you out, maybe get you to the toilet and back to bed. But come onto your side. If you're on your back, bend your knees, roll over. Everyone use your top hand, press to come up. Just come to whatever position is comfortable for you right now. Let's inhale, shoulders to ears, exhale, shoulders down. And just bring your hands to your heart. Breathing in and out through your nose, connect to your breath. And especially honor yourself for taking time for you. When we look after ourselves, everybody else around us benefits too. Well done, everyone. Namaste. Thanks so much. I hope you have a lovely sleep tonight.